horror. A man who saved the earth now lay beneath the sod, and you know it's true. You got to take the love and pass it on. The sun goes down and comes back again at dawn. An old man dies and another child is born. Take the love and pass it on. When I was growing up, the Vietnam War raged on the TV. The world had gone insane, sometimes so it seemed to me. But the love was all around, a billion grains of sand. The moment came and went for a minute. It was grand. It all came clear to me when I held your little hand in mine, and it's true. You've got to take the love and pass it on. The sun goes down and comes back again at dawn. An old man dies and another child. Take the love and pass it on.
Traveling song. It's my newest song. I have two sons who live in Asheville, North Carolina. And my oldest has been there about 10 years. He got married last year. And I was visiting this summer. I was on my way down. I wrote this song on the plane. No guitar in my hand. I just came up with it. And I wrote the verse and the chorus. And I was singing it for my family on the beach. I have a little travel guitar. And I couldn't come up with the second verse, so I asked my oldest son, I said, could you take these lyrics, you know, follow up on the first and write another verse, and he did. And it's called Going to North Carolina. I working all summer just to try to make a dollar, man, a long, hard mountain to climb. Sweating in the kitchen and I'll listen to the bitching. It's enough to make a fella lose his mind. I'm tired of pulling doubles, wanna forget about my troubles, looking just to have a good time. So I'm leaving in the morning, giving no one any warning, gonna head down to North Carolina. Guitar, maybe some fishing gear. Going to North Carolina, where the mockingbirds sing all night long, and where the girls all look so pretty in the country and the city. That's why I'm singing the song. Dodgers packed up, I'm ready to fly. Sick of rushing freeways, no porches for some leeway. Want some grits and biscuits, okra on the side. Sipping moonshine in a holler, even if I spend my last dollar, I'm happy that I took this ride. Cause when the sun comes up in Tennessee, there's just no place I'd rather be. You know that place is North Carolina. Going to North Carolina. No guitar, maybe some fishing gear. I'm going to North Carolina, where the mockingbirds sing all night long, where the girls all look so pretty in the country and the city. That's why I'm singing this song. Where the girls all look so pretty in the country and the city. That's why I'm singing this song. Many styles tonight. This next one is a little tale of barroom romance. All started out with a pickup line. What part of heaven are you from? She drifts across the room. Her smile lights up the night. She's an angel with a pool cue in her hand. I know the room is crowded, she's the only one I see. And if you could have been there, I know you'd understand. I'd like to go and talk to her, but I hold myself in check at the risk of saying something dumb. But then something takes a hold of me, and I can't help myself. And I say, what part of heaven are you from? What part of heaven are you from? As can be expected, she looks at me kind of strange, but has the grace to simply tell me thanks. And then she goes back to her table, turns and looks me in the eye as she pockets the 10 ball off the bank. And now the ice is broken, my heart is in her hand. I wish that I could be her only one. And then a playful little smile comes across her pretty face. What part of heaven are you from? What part of heaven are you from? band, it's pretty good. Guitar gets my attention for a while. I had a song with my buddy Ray. He got married, then divorced. I told him, try not to ever lose your smile. Then I look around the barroom. She's nowhere to be found. The music's over, it's late. The night is done. Silly little question. Well, that's all that I have left. What part of heaven are you from? What part of heaven are you from? No other south, east or west. You never told me, huh? What part of heaven are you from? I'll search the earth for you, cause I know that you're the one. What part of heaven? Tell me, what part of heaven? What part of heaven are you from? First. Nobody wants to go first, but going first is nice because then you're not thinking about your set list and when you're going to go, you know, maybe I should do this song after that one. So thanks, Barry.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay, this next song is a little dark. Drop D tuning. There was a prison camp in the Civil War. It's called Andersonville. It's down in Georgia. Really a horrible place. It was towards the end of the war. It was only open for 14 months. And 45,000 Union soldiers were in prison there. Out of those 15,000 died. And it was no food, unsanitary conditions. Turned 21 in 1910, carrying a heavy load. Dark clouds gathered in a foreign land, up and hit the road. And in a hobo jungle near Midwest town, between the river and the railroad tracks, I met an ancient man with haunted eyes and a story to be back. Lion had crumbled on a Chickamauga morn. Amid the smoke and anguish, a man and I were drawn. The Johnnies were our captors when they shuffled us for miles until we came upon Camp Sumter. The stockade touched the sky. Andersonville, there's never been such a hell on earth, and I know there never will. My soul survived, but I left my soul in the squalor and the swill. A place that God forgot about, Andersonville. Gates were open to us, the stench had filled the air. The men once were soldiers, too weak to even care. Faces drawn in hunger, and clothes in tattered rags, 1,000 pounds of dark despair, stuffed in a 10-pound bag. When nighttime came and darkness fell, the Union raiders roamed, scavenging what was little left their northern brothers owned. For bathing drink and human waste, the Stockade branch did run, all the while underneath a blazing southern sun. There's never been such a hell on earth, and I know there never will. My bones survived, but I left my soul in the squalor and the swill. A place that God forgot about, Andersonville. Now my wandering days are over. I've wandered and I've wondered about pain and death and war. I've seen the beauty of God's creatures and the wonders of this land. I don't know how the glory and the horror can mingle hand in hand. And then the old man closed his eyes, and he dropped his can of stew. I felt a ghostly shiver, I knew his roaming days were through. And as the fire slowly died, I thought of doughboys and big guns. We've come so far, and the lessons learned, and the circle turns again. Andersonville, never been such a hell on earth, and I know they never will. My bones survived, but I left my soul in the squalor and the swill, a place that God forgot about, Andersonville, a place that God never knew about. Hope I didn't depress you too much with that one. Thank you. You know, I forgot in the introduction to tell you, maybe you picked it up, but that was told from the point of view of a young hobo right before World War I was about to start. And he met this old guy who was a survivor of not only the Civil War, but Andersonville. So that's the story. So this next one is kind of a love story. It's about a little bit about obsession. I will be thinking about you tonight. I will be thinking about you when the moonlight shines through a window pane and turns my world to blue. Somewhere else it's shining down on you, and I'm wondering, do you think about me too? It's been a long time since I'd seen her. I met her in a crowded room. She said, I'm glad you made it. Infatuated, said it's nice to see you too. And tonight I will be thinking about you. I will be thinking about you tonight. I will be thinking about you. When the moonlight shines through my window pane and turns my world to blue, somewhere else it's shining down on you. And I'm wondering, do you think about me too? And then you leaned in close beside me. We talked about our glory days. We talked about our sorrows and our yesterday's tomorrows. And then we went our separate ways. And when I close my eyes, I still can't see your face. I will be thinking about you tonight. I will be thinking about you. When the moonlight shines through my window pane and turns my world blue, tonight I will be thinking. I'll be stinking and I'll be drinking. Tonight I will be thinking about you. Song is about that time in everybody's life. Some love to hate it, some hate to love it. It's called High School. I grew up in Queens, Bayside. Yeah, I hear a lot of those accents. Oh, okay. So did I. Went to a Catholic school, and this is a bit autobiographical. Back in high school, I used to sleep a lot. Must have been from drinking beer, smoking too much pot. The girls looked fine and were all around, but somehow out of reach. We used to cut our classes and hitchhike to the beach. I never liked the taste of cigarettes, but I smoked them, so I took cool. When I was back, when I was in high school, when I was back in high school, I knew the geeks and the punks. I was friends with the hippies and the greasers, the dope addicts and the drunks. Teachers, they all knew me well. They said, stay away from that crowd. My parents just said, cut your hair and don't play your music so loud. And I was the quiet rebel. I got my kicks by breaking the rules. When I was back, when I was in high school, back in high school, around 1972, thought it was the eve of destruction, we didn't have a clue. When I was back in high school, 1974, rock and roll was in the air, and we all wanted more, more, more. When I was back in high school, I learned to play guitar. I used to practice all night long till my fingers were red and sore. When I was back in high school, I met some freaks like me. We used to practice in my friend's garage and try and stay in key. I never thought that I was gonna be a star, but still, it felt pretty cool. When I was back, when I was in high school. Thank you all so much. Thanks, guys.